Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now, let us see about 100 conversion in organic chemistry. We are seeing it as episodes. I am happy to inform you that this is the episode number 75. Every episode, we solve 5 problems. So, we solve around 400 problems so far. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. I want to dedicate this episode to the legendary teacher and researcher, my great inspiration, Professor George Whitesides, from the Department of Chemistry, Harvard University. He is from States. He is a true master of simplicity in teaching and research. So I owe him a lot. He influenced me in every possible way. Let us see the question number 1. The starting metal is a 6-member system with oxygen and which is conjugation with the double bond. Then you are using the chlorinated acid chloride and zinc copper couple. The same product they ask you to find from the different one, which is a 4-member ring, which is the same product but 4-member strained ring with carbonyl and Cl2. Here, 2 reactions give the same product. They ask you to find it. So basically they are asking the products from 2 different starting metal, both supposed to be 1. Here, products are cyclized 1, the position of CO and O is the real question here. So, from the reagent, you might guess one naming reaction is involved. So, definitely ring formation is occurred there. The answer is D. Let us see how. The starting metal, you have the chloride and you are using the zinc copper couple. Here, zinc abstract the chlorine there. Here, you have heating kind of structure with cumulative double bond. Then this reacts with our starting material. So this one act like enophile because it have electron withdrawing group 2 chlorine. So it's a enophile and starting metal is alkene. So definitely you might expect 2+2 cycloaddition. So the product is clearly D. The same product obtained from the Bayer-Villiger oxidation, the another starting metal, the B pathway. It is defined by the migrating ability, which is tertiary one migrate faster when compared to secondary. So you got the same product. Why this question is asked? Why this 2 version of question is important? From the research point of view, it is very much important because the same product can be obtained from cheaper reagent or 2-step or 1-step. A pathway is 2-step. Initially you form starting metal, then you go for it. The B form is straightforward and straight away. Then you have to think of metal-free reaction. The first one contains metal, zinc, copper couple. Second one is almost metal-free reaction. So, this is the research method. You have to choose the starting metal and product. Then, let us see the question number 2. The starting metal is the 5-member ring with hydroxygen, which is in conjugated with alkene. Then, you have aromaticity in the 5th position. Then, you are using iodonaphthalene. You are using palladium and quaternary ammonium salt. Then, you are using the quaternary ammonium salt and potassium salt and phosphine. Here 4 products are given. The products are carbon-carbon coupled one definitely. And the regio select is the real question. Whether the bond is occurred between first carbon or second carbon. The position of double bond in the second one or third one is the real question. So here position of double bond and position of naphthalene attack is important there. So from the reagents you might guess the naming reaction is involved. And regio selectivity also important here. Answer is D. Let us see how. The starting metal contains iodine, you are using the palladium reagent. So, you might guess it's a Heck kind of coupling. So, the complex is formed at first step. Then you have another starting metal which have alkene there. So, coupling has to be occur. Here, the first carbon is better ligand due to the oxygen donation. Oxygen is the electron withdrawing group. So, the attack is happen on 1, not on 2. So, new CC bond is formed there. Let us draw a very clean way for the product formation. Then you have palladium and 2 beta hydrogen. Here the green hydrogen is removed because of its possible double bond way. The another beta hydrogen cannot be removed. If you remove, you violate the valency there. So green proton is removed there. So you have answer D. Here you have to learn 2 important things. Whenever you have palladium catalyst with aryl halide, you might think of Heck coupling. Second thing is you have to choose the selectivity based on the electron density. Here oxygen donates and improve the electron density at first position. then whenever the competition between beta hydrogens, you might think of stability and possible quenching pathway. The starting metal is a linear chain with alkene and alcohol. You are using positive DET, titanium isopropoxide and peracid there. Then you are using the thiol and base. They ask you to find the product. The products are stereochemically different. Whether the dihydroxylation occur or one hydroxylation replaced by phenyl, there is the real question. So you have to guess whether the both hydroxyl groups are same. So you have to guess whether the hydroxyl groups are in anti-position or syn position, or it is replaced by thiophenol. So you have to guess stereochemistry. So you have to focus on stereochemistry. From the reagents, you might guess two naming reactions is involved, and definitely stereochemistry also played the role there. The answer is B. Let us see how. The starting metal contain alcohol, you are using the DET and titanium isopropoxide. You might guess it's a SAR plus epoxidation. Since it's a trans alkene plus DET, the alkene is epoxide in the below position. It's a guided oxidation, so alkene is formed in the below position. Next step, you are using the base. Base subtract the proton, you have O- there. Then you have strained system and charged basis. It is a kind of pain rearrangement. What happens is O- attack the ring, it is also form epoxide. One epoxide open and another epoxide form there. This reaction is called pain rearrangement. Here main driving force is ring strain here. Next step, you are using the thiol, it open the ring. The attack is on the less crowded side, so it is attack on the end, you have thiol there. If you rewrite properly, it's the product B. Here you have to learn two naming reaction. One is SAR plus reaction. SAR plus reaction is epoxide formation. If you have plus DET and trans alkene, it is below the plane and pain rearrangement. If you have epoxide and near to the O- system, the quenching and strain promote the reaction. So you have epoxide formation again. Then the question number 4. The starting metal is linear chain attached with 5 member and benzene. 5 member contain conjugated ketone. In the connected position, it has one methyl group. You are using the light, they ask you to find the product. Here many products are possible. The products are like 5 member, 6 member or open chain or ring expanded product. From the product and reactant, you might guess carbon skeleton changes definitely occur and the quenching pathway dictate the reaction. The answer is C. Let us see how. The starting metal contains carbonyl, you are using the light. So carbonyl bonds are weaker, it open with light, form diradical. Here radical is near to the double bond, so the radical travels. The radical has to be quenched, so quenching pathway can be generating another radical. Here third hydrogen removes and forms the radical there. So the radical formation is occurred there. So you have 1,3 diradical there, it has to find the quenching pathway. So what really happens is two hydrogen leaves and it form the double bond at 2,3 position. So 2,3 double bond is formed new there. So in the same time, enol converted into ketone due to heteroenol tautomerism, you have product C. There are many quenching pathways in this one. The radical can be combined in any way. Always you have to go for stable product. Here you can go with the same procedure with the radical formation, but if you end up with a big member or unstable ring, it is not possible. This is the major stable product, which is C. Here you have to learn two important things. Whenever you have carbonyl, you are using the light mean, you have diradical, then the radical is formed, you might think of quenching pathway. While quenching, you have to consider the stable pathway means it form extended conjugation or it form the stable ring sizes. The other pathways lead to 8 member ring or unstable pathway or no conjugation. So whenever you have radical, you have to find a meaningful quenching pathway. Then the question number 5. The starting metal is a linear system with many functional groups. It contains alkene, it contains cyclopropyl, it contains alcohol and methyl. You are using HBr at low temperature. They ask you to find the product. The products are mostly brominated one. The position of bromine is the real question. And the question also suggests that the ring openings occur or not. So you have to understand that ring strain versus reaction is the real question. The answer is C. Let us see how. The starting metal contains many functional groups. You are using the HBr. One might think of the alkyne is reacting, but it's a low temperature reaction, so it's unfavorable by alkane reaction. So the substitution is favorable here. So instead of breaking many bonds, the substitution is favorable here. Hence, OH reaction is favorable. So what really happened is the reaction promoted by acidity of HBr. It's an acid, so it protonates the alcohol. So alcohol is protonated, it forms the cation. The cation is a tertiary cation. Then what really happened is you have the strain-full 3-member ring. So the strain-full 3-member ring opens. You have the cation formed at the end position. There bromine attacks, you have the product C. The driving force for this reaction is ring strain. Ring strain promotes the charge travel here. What is special here? Because it's contradicting the fundamental. Normally you study cation stabilities primary, secondary and tertiary. Here you are going from tertiary compound to secondary compound, or you can say stable to unstable. By thinking wise, it is impossible. But the ring strain promotes the reaction here. It's very much important. So you have to think of system when you consider the stability. Here you have to learn two important things. The first thing is low temperature alkyne don't react. Only the acidity promote the reaction. Second thing is ring strain is very high. It always open at any cost, even though to unstability. That's all from this episode. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. Stay tuned for next episode.